that maybe there was a third party situation. So for different people, it's going to resonate in different ways. For some of you, it was a third party situation. For others of you, this person was just a narcissistic, low level bitch who was trying to play games with you. They were trying to involve a third party. And I see the connection basically came down. I see that now you're trying to maintain yourself, like you're trying to maintain your calm. You're trying to focus on better new things. That's what the Two of Wands. You're trying to basically unstuck yourself from a situation and you're trying to move on. Like you're just trying to carry forward your life. But I see there was a lot and lot of pressure that was created on you because there's like a clear loss. Like this felt like a very deep loss to you. So I see that you might have taken a lot of time to come out of this. It was difficult with the Five of Cups and the Three of Swords and Five of Wands. This was a very difficult situation for you. I see some of you, maybe this happened 5 months back or 5 weeks back. I don't know what it is. But yeah, 5 could be a very significant number. And you know, 555 is also a number of big changes. So I see that now your life is going to take big changes. It's going to turn in a better way. But for that, you had to first go through this shit. And only then it's going to happen. So yeah, I definitely see a lot has happened in your life. And it has really changed you, or it is already changing you, all right? Okay, what else? Ten of Swords. Who the fuck are you dealing with, Scorpio? Who is this person? They have hurt you beyond limits. Beyond limits. Some of it's a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Could be another water sign. Could be a fire sign. I cannot see earth sign so far. For some of you, it could be. But these signs are really prominent. I see somebody has really backstabbed you. This person was playing nasty mind games. And they were just trying to manipulate you. And this has been a very tough ending, but the good thing is that you're still maintaining your calm and you're still holding yourself up. So you are showing as a very strong person. Like if people would be seeing you, they might not be realizing that you are going through so much. So you're maintaining yourself really well in spite of whatever has happened. And I see a lot of turbulence has happened recently. You're trying to move on from the situation with the Six of Swords. You're trying to heal, you're trying to prioritize some other things, you're trying to slowly and gradually move towards calm waters, but you have gone through a lot is what I see. So it is definitely difficult, like it's going to take some time. Hold on. What else? Your cards are just flying. Five of Swords. I see that you were dealing with somebody who just wants to win at any cost, like one of those people. They just want to win, even if it's meant to, you know, even if they have to walk over somebody, they would still want to win and they will never give up. They will not consider humanity and etc. You know, you might be dealing with somebody who is so, so bad. Like they just wanted to win at any condition and they did not hesitate from hurting you as well. Very opportunist, narcissistic kind of person you were dealing with. This person was also trying to overpower you. For some of you, this could be workplace drama as well, and we already have 555 here. So yeah, like, you know, this could be a blessing in disguise for you. I know that when you're going through all of this, you're very deeply hurt. But, you know, the 555, again, it's a number of big changes. And all of this happens after big, big turmoil and big turbulence. So I see that you are definitely feeling a lot of turbulence right now. But things are going to get better, all right? That's what it is. It's just asking you to have patience and kind of manage through, sail through the situation. Keep your calm and sail through because better days are ahead, all right? With the World card, I also see travel. So some of you might be traveling very soon or you are already in the process. Or if you want to travel, then the message is that yes, you will be very soon. Nine of Wands. I see new passion coming into your life with the Knight of Wands and the World card, which is going to bring in all that lost hope in your life. Like right now, you might not be very hopeful about the situation. Like you're trying to sail through, but you're still not very hopeful about the situation. It kind of hurts you when you look back. But the good thing is that the hope and the enthusiasm and the passion is going to be restored in your life through some means. I don't know, you might be doing really well in your career. people will appreciate you and you will feel really better about yourself. You will basically regain your self-confidence. I see somebody basically made you feel in a certain way, which has really hampered your self-confidence. Now you've become very cautious, and your Scorpios becoming cautious is something, because I think Scorpios are one of the most beautiful and passionate people, and they have so much to offer to the other person, but somebody really made you feel in a certain way, because of which you might not be feeling very confident in yourself lately. But yeah, all of this is going to change with the Knight of One and the World card. All right, I also see that somebody, maybe a fire sign, might be coming towards you with a lot of passion, or maybe there's a Aquarius, Scorpio, Leo, or a Taurus coming towards you with a lot of passion. Page of Sword. Meanwhile, your past person, this narcissistic person, is also keeping tabs on you. So somebody's keeping tabs on you. And with the Mercury retrograde, it makes sense as well. I see somebody still very closely watches you. They watch your every move. They want to know what's up with you. And that's the biggest thing with narcissistic people, right? They never really leave your life. And I was reading this quote somewhere that the most toxic people usually fight the hardest to stay in your life, because they don't want you to end the toxic cycle, right? They want to keep feeding off of you. So yeah, I see that these kind of narcissistic people, they just leave, they come back, they leave, they come back. So yeah, somebody might try to do that, so be very careful. Okay, what else for Scorpio, please? Two of Cups. Yeah, I definitely see love showing up for you. Some of you could be with another water sign. But yeah, you might be meeting somebody which is going to be very fulfilling and very emotional kind of connection. So this, you know, your past person was very manipulative. They used a lot of brain, like they were not using emotions as much. They were just all about brain. But this next person who's coming towards you is going to be very sensual and very emotional. And they would be your friend first and then a connection, because Three of Cups is here with the Two of Cups. So this could be a friendship turning into relationship. You might meet this person through your friend circle, or maybe in your local network, right? Like through your friends, through cousins, or maybe at your workplace. So yeah, I see that happening. Somebody could become a friend first and then a relationship. Some of you also feel that you are just very much focused on your work, because there is something that you really want to achieve in your work with the Three of Pentacles, right? Like you're putting in work and you will be appreciated for your work as well. These days you're just maybe working in groups and teams, and you're working on a project or something, maybe in business as well, I don't know what it is, but you're very passionate towards achieving something because you want to have this moment of celebration. So some of you, maybe it's an exam or a course you're undertaking, or I don't know what it is, but like you're very passionately focused on getting results here so that you can celebrate. So whatever it is, if you're working for that, you will be able to celebrate. That's the message. If you're putting in the hard work, you are going to get it. And I see very slowly and steadily, you are very focused on career or money. Something about career and money is very prominent here. And you're going full in, and things are going to give you results, so don't worry. Right now, you might be feeling the stress or the burden that, oh my God, I'm preparing, I will get result or not. Will this happen or not? I'm putting in so much. Will it be appreciated by other people? Your message is that it will be. It's going to be a wish fulfillment with the Nine of Cups. You just have to go for it, all right? You don't have to think about it as much. Don't worry about the future. Don't worry about the result. Right now, be in the moment and put in the work. And there could be other people who try to put you down with the Five of Wands and the Five of Swords and the Five of Cups. Be very careful, right? Do not try to discuss your secrets with other people is what I would suggest you. Because there are people who are trying to create drama in your environment. Give me some energy about this past person of Scorpio. Nine of Wands. They're still waiting for you. This person is still waiting for you. Queen of Wands. This person still has some passion for you. They are seeing that you're doing really good for yourself. This person was very toxic and very narcissistic, so there's no point of going back to this person. I would suggest you that. But they still have their eyes on you. This person might be feeling that because now you're doing really well in your life, so you're ignoring them. Or maybe they just feel that you are moving on because you're so focused on yourself. Somebody sees that you are very determined to achieve something in life and you're going full-fledged. And they recognize that you're very busy with your own life, that you don't have time for them, or you don't have time for their drama, basically. Four of Pentacles. You are very determined about something, is what I see. See, you're very, very determined. King of Wands. Ooh. Whatever you're aiming for, especially if it's for power or money or for some sort of stability, I see that's gonna happen. Some of you are getting some sort of recognition in your work because you're putting in a lot of work. You're being very adamant about this win, like you want to win at any cost. And you will win because you're putting in so much work. And somebody also recognizes that you have realized your self-worth. So this person is very scared to mess with you because they know that you will not allow them so easily in their life back. In your life back, I'm sorry. Right now, these days, I see that you have become a person who is very concerned about their life and you don't want to put up with anybody's crap because you feel that this person does not deserve a second chance because they caused so much drama in your life. So you're being very skeptical about that as well. Ace of Pentacles. Yeah, see, so I see that you have walked away from this past person and you're seeking for something new and more meaningful and more stable in your life with the Ace of Pentacles. You're trying to slowly move towards stability and you do not want drama, is what I see. And you're seeking for new things. You feel that the past was very toxic. Now you're looking for stability and you're looking for something which feels like a wish fulfillment. Some of you might be manifesting this as well. So you're really hoping for a very solid connection coming in, and that is gonna happen. And you know, I don't know for what reason, I see that these days you're very focused on money, either money or maybe a career or a position or maybe an exam of your, I don't know what it is, but something about career or money is very prominent that you're working, and I see you are going to get it. Some of you, you're also trying to take new direction. Yeah, with the Eight of Swords, like this person was really keeping you stuck and now you want to move ahead in life. You want to go in a new direction. So it's like you're picking up yourself and you're moving in new direction because you have realized that you wasted a lot of time on this person and now you don't want that to happen in your life again. This person, whoever this was, they really, really burdened you. Like they really messed with your brain, is what I see. You could really not see a direction out of this person. What was the obstacle with this person? What was the obstacle? Knight of Cups and the Eight of Wands. Somebody, you know, I see there was love between you and them initially, definitely, but the obstacle was that this person used to come in and leave very soon. So they were not very consistent. You never really got that kind of stability from this person. They used to come and leave at the same speed. And they were also being very, very stubborn. They were just not giving you what you wanted. Like you wanted a Knight of Cup kind of a relationship, something which was emotionally fulfilling and etc. But they just kept hiding things. They were just not opening up. They were just trying to lie to you. I don't know. Messy person, Ace of Cups. See, you were looking for this, didn't I tell you? You were looking for emotional fulfillment and they were just very in and out. And they were just not focusing on you as much. Because of which you felt really discontent in the connection. Okay, what new is coming towards Scorpio? What else is coming towards Scorpio? Wow, soulmate connection. Some of you, a very, very meaningful, long-lasting connection is coming up for you with the Ace of Cups, Ace of Pentacles, and the Sun card. This does not look like a past person. I see this is a new person. As I already said, they could be a friend turning to lover, or maybe you meet them through your network circle, like the smaller network circle. I see a lot of abundance and fulfillment coming in for you if you go for the new. Or if you keep going, all right, you are already moving. I see you're already detaching yourself from the past person. If you keep going, it's going to happen for you. And these days, I see you have become very competent in your life about a goal of your certain goal. Keep doing that because I see success. So whatever you're trying to aim, you will get it. King of Pentacles. Do I have to say anything else? Lot of stability in the Nine of Cups. I think this has come for the third time. Like I saw this for the third time in your reading. It is definitely talking about wish fulfillment when it comes to stability. I see you're seeking stability, be it career or be it relationship. Like you are basically done with dealing with low level fuckboy, fuckgirls. You want stable person and I see that's coming in, but it's gonna come in a little slow. So be ready for that. And it is always better that if something is slow than never, right? So yeah, it is coming in slow, and it's going to be a new person. So keep going, all right? Don't try to go back to the past person who is already sneaking in your life. They are a complete waste of time, all right? A past person will try to waste your time. Please don't go back. Because they've already put you through third party situation. They made you doubt yourself. They just never gave you what you wanted. Like, you can never change a Satan, right? All right. Message for Scorpio, please. True love. Do I have to say, Scorpio, you're getting the best reading for this week. Like, this is such a beautiful reading. You will get to know each other, which means you might not be knowing this new person, or maybe you just know them very vaguely, right? As I said, it could be a friend, or maybe friend of friend, or a new person in your work area. You never really saw them before. I don't know. So you don't really know each other very, very well. You will get to know them really well. And it's a true love. But it's going to happen with a little delay, alright? So be careful about that. Don't try to rush things. And keep an open mind. These days you might not be very open, because, you know, somebody has really created a lot of push and pull and chaos in your love life is what I see. And because of which you also don't know whether to move on, whether to go back. Some of you, sometimes you have this confusion. Am I doing right by moving on? Is this the right decision? Of course it is. This person has broken your heart over and over again. Three of sword, ten of sword. I mean, it was so toxic. There's no point of going back to a toxic person, right? Trash is not meant to be dated. Trash is meant to be dumped. I said in one more reading of mine, and I thought that I should repeat it for you. So yeah, that was a very beautiful reading. Hope this helps resonate. If it resonate, then do give a like, share, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in the next video. Till then, you guys take care, stay safe, bye.